Are Banjo-Kazooie coming their way to the Nintendo Switch? With a recent leak from Amazon, let's discuss whether or not this is true right now.
I got hot sauce in my bag. Swag.
A quick shout out to Pack the Weeb. This is a fan art of Metal Duckles that they drew for me. And you know what? Metal Duckles just looks so wholesome here. I really like the big smile on his face in particular. So thank you so much for this. I really appreciate it. Anyway, hello dear beautiful human. My name is RyderCX and welcome to my channel. Where today we're going to talk a little bit more about Banjo-Kazooie. And first of all, I just gotta say thank you so much to the success of my first Banjo video. Like the amount of views I'm getting on it right now and all the comments I'm getting talking about Banjo-Kazooie. Like it really shocked me because you know I've never made a Banjo video before, but this just proves to me that there's a lot of interest around this franchise right now, and it's really exciting to see like what Rare and Microsoft and Nintendo might be thinking of all this attention and just kind of like speculating about what we could see in the future. And so what I decided to do this video is like I was so overwhelmed first of all by like the amount of attention the video got. I was like, okay, I need to make another video about this, kind of expanding upon the topic, and I was just kind of wondering what video I could make. So I went to my Twitter actually and asked people on my Twitter what I should make a video on, and these are a couple of comments I got. Steven Troy Benson said, will hashtag Rare Replay ever come to the Nintendo Switch? And then meanwhile, Udis Le Pudis asked, what could a potential Banjo 3 be about? And there's something really clear to me from these comments is the fact that people are really interested in what's coming next for Banjo-Kazooie. And so, this was a leak that I saw a while back that I was kind of debating like making news upon, but I think this would be a good thing to discuss just to determine whether or not this is a real thing and what we could expect from the future. So this is a tweet that I found from the Brought Back Banjo Twitter page, and they said, a mysterious listing has popped up on Amazon Germany for a potential new Banjo game for Switch. And then as you see here, there's a picture of the Banjo-Kazooie listing on German Amazon. And what's really interesting also is that I found this article on GoNintendo.com that had an update where apparently there was a user named Bellboy that was able to get in contact with Amazon Germany, and this is what Amazon Germany had said. Hi Dustin, stay tuned for more info. We don't have anything on Banjo-Kazooie at the moment, but just keep an eye on the website for a little bit. Greetings. And so that's very interesting, you know? I wonder if there is something in the works for Banjo in terms of the Nintendo Switch. It's one thing for like a retailer to mistakenly put up a listing on a future title that hasn't been announced yet, but it's another thing for the retailer to actually say something about that. They didn't outright deny that this was a real thing. They just kind of said like, we don't have anything yet, but they said to keep an eye for a little bit. And so that's a little bit interesting, and I'm not really sure what to make of it. Although some time has gone by since that tweet has been made, and there really hasn't been any other updates as far as I know of. So I actually decided to go onto the Amazon page myself and see if there were any changes to it, and this was what I found when I went onto the Amazon page. It looks like the listing has been removed as of now from the page, as it says currently not available. And this is a translated page, by the way, because this is on the Amazon Germany page, so I had to translate it so I could see what was going on. And so it looks like they removed the listing, and the listing being removed could be for two reasons. One reason could be because it is official, but Nintendo and Microsoft did not want them to list it yet, so they urged them to remove it immediately. Or two, it was made by mistake, and there's actually nothing confirmed so far in terms of Banjo-Kazooie on the Switch beyond the Super Smash Bros. DLC. And so, here's what I'm thinking. In my honest opinion, I don't think there's anything planned right now, if I had to be truly honest with y'all. Like, from what I gathered, especially from my last video that I made about this game, I don't think Nintendo and Microsoft really understood just how much support there is for a Banjo-Kazooie return, you know, beyond a Super Smash Bros. DLC, you know, having him in an actual game, whether it be like a remake, a remaster, or a brand new Banjo 3, you know, I don't think they truly understood the impact that this reveal was gonna have. And so that's why I don't think anything is being worked on right now. And I honestly think that Amazon Germany probably made that preemptively, thinking that there was gonna be something, or maybe they like misinterpreted something. So I don't know. Also, I did read some comments on Twitter and YouTube that it could be like an amiibo for Banjo-Kazooie. Are amiibos still a thing? I thought they were just there for like the Nintendo Wii U and not for the Switch, but if amiibos are still a real thing, then it could very well be a Banjo-Kazooie amiibo, but let me know whether or not that's still a real thing or not in the comment section below. I will say this, I do think that Microsoft and Nintendo are very much taking into account just how big the reaction is, and the reason for that is because the reaction is just so big, it's so enormous that it's impossible to ignore. This is a tweet that I found from someone named Ryan Brown, and here's what he said. Interesting factoid, Banjo-Kazooie coming to Smash has been more talked about and reported on than anything at Xbox's E3 conference. Would be nice to see a new Banjo game come out of this very clear popularity for the series. And this is an image that he shared over here, and in various things such as like video coverage, Twitter coverage, or Facebook coverage, you see that Banjo-Kazooie is up there, at least above anything that Microsoft announced. So this is a really clear like sign to Microsoft at least that there is a lot of interest for Banjo-Kazooie in the future, and you know, Microsoft owns the IP. I mean, it will always feel like a Nintendo IP to me, but Microsoft owns it and it's the most popular thing to come out of the like lineup, so I really do hope Microsoft at least sees the potential that the Banjo-Kazooie name has right now and starts to get working on something. Also, other people very heavily involved with Banjo-Kazooie such as Rare and some of their developers have taken notice of the attention as well. Just wanted to let you know that we're seeing and loving all the responses and eardrum bursting reaction videos to Banjo and Kazooie in Smash Bros. Ultimate. Enormous care was taken on both sides to make sure this was done right, and its reception is a joy to behold. Thank you all. Steve Miles says, Twitter went a bit mad for me since yesterday for some reason. Thanks for all the messages, I've tried to read them all. Grant Kirkhope says, I've been watching some fan reaction videos on YouTube and seeing people totally lose it with happiness is so genuinely touching. I think I shed a tear every time. Video games really are something. And so, to me, it seems like all the important people at least have taken notice of Banjo-Kazooie really like making a big splash in terms of gaming coverage at this year's E3. Now, here's a last point I want to bring up in terms of the future of Banjo-Kazooie, and that is, what should be the next step? And this is something that I'm really curious about. So say that this Nintendo Switch listing is real and that it does point to like an actual game. What should that game be? Should it be a brand new Banjo-Kazooie game, or should it be like a remake slash remaster of the Banjo-Kazooie games that came before? And here's what I think about this. I think Banjo-Kazooie is the perfect example of a franchise that absolutely needs a remaster slash remake. There's a whole lot of remaster remakes that are going out right now, such as Crash, Spyro, Medieval, and now SpongeBob is a really big one in particular for me. And here's the thing about SpongeBob in particular that I really want to bring up. You know, SpongeBob Battle for Bikini Bottom came out in 2003. So it's been, what, 16 years since that game came out and it's getting a remake? In my personal opinion, I don't think Battle for Bikini Bottom really needed a remake. And here's a couple reasons for this and why I think Banjo-Kazooie is different. So SpongeBob, even though Battle for Bikini Bottom is by far like the most iconic game in the SpongeBob series, SpongeBob has had a pretty healthy amount of games come out since then. I mean, you had Creature from the Krusty Krab, Atlantis SquarePantis, Truth or Square, the really bad Activision games in particular. You even had Nickelodeon Kart Racers come out last year. So SpongeBob has had like a somewhat noticeable gaming presence for a while. It's just that obviously none of those games compare to like Battle for Bikini Bottom or the movie game. But with Banjo-Kazooie, Banjo has been pretty much absent for a really long time. I mean, the last time we had like a Banjo game was Nuts and Bolts, and I think that came out in like 2009, 2008, I'm not sure. Either way, that would be like 10 years at least. And 10 years is a really long time to go without a franchise. And some people can even argue that Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts doesn't even feel like a true Banjo game. You know, the last true Banjo game could have been like Banjo-Tooie for a lot of people, and that came out even further back. And so the point is, Banjo-Kazooie has been gone for a very long time. And a lot of people that are interested in the franchise now are brand new people that have never played the games before. Like, take me for example. I've never played Banjo-Kazooie before, but I'm really interested in the franchise and I really want to try it out. And so I think a remake or remaster or even just ports of the Banjo-Kazooie games would be a really great idea, especially if you can get it onto the Nintendo Switch, because most Banjo fans, I feel like, are Nintendo owners. You know, that's just the reality of it. Like, even though Microsoft brought Banjo-Kazooie, Banjo's home was truly always with Nintendo, no matter how you want to spin it. And so I think a remake or remaster of the first Banjo games is absolutely crucial in introducing Banjo back to the audiences. And here's another point I want to bring up in terms of like the people that would be making or handling this remake slash remaster. So a lot of people had argued that like the Rare that we have right now is not the Rare that we had back then when they made these Banjo games. And that's pretty much true for the most part. I mean, most of the original developers left Rare to become Playtonic Games, who recently made Yooka-Laylee and are coming out with another game, I think, later this year. And so most of the people that would be working on this game probably aren't that familiar with how Banjo-Kazooie works in terms of gameplay mechanics. So I think a remake slash remaster would be the perfect way to get those people up to date of how Banjo-Kazooie feels and what fans really loved about the game, what fans didn't love about the game. And this is the same case with like Crash and Spyro, you know, having like Vicarious Visions and Toys for Bob make those games and really just get to know like how Crash feels or how Spyro feels, and maybe possibly incorporating those elements into a brand new game is something that's a really good idea when you're bringing back a franchise that's been dormant for a while. And so that's another reason why Banjo remake slash remaster would be a really great idea, and I really hope we see that, especially for me, because I'm definitely not willing to buy a Microsoft console just to play old Nintendo 64 games. I'd much rather they bite the bullet and port the games to the Nintendo Switch. Now, I don't think it's very realistic to see the whole Rare Replay game ported to the Switch. I mean, it'd be really great because, first of all, I love Viva Pinata, so it'd be so awesome to see Viva Pinata on the Switch, but a lot of these games are Microsoft exclusives, and I highly doubt Microsoft would be willing to have so many of their exclusive games be ported to the Nintendo Switch. I mean, I know they did with Cuphead, but that's one game. I really doubt they would go for a whole collection of exclusive games, but I think I could envision them at least letting Banjo games go over to the Nintendo Switch. So just having a nice little Banjo collection on Nintendo Switch coming out later this year would be a really great thing, you know. If it's just a port, then fine. If it's a remake, then even better. But just have something. Have something to capitalize off of this attention and really get people's eyes on Banjo-Kazooie again, because people are waiting for something to come out Banjo-Kazooie now. Like, this should not be it. It should not just be a Smash Bros. DLC and that's it. There should be more, because clearly the interest is there for Banjo-Kazooie. I mean, my last video in terms of how well it did just kind of speaks for itself. You know, I never made a Banjo video before and it just blew up, absolutely blew up. And that is a testament to how excited people are for Banjo-Kazooie coming back. But I want to hear your thoughts in the comment section below. What would you like to see from Banjo-Kazooie if this Nintendo Switch title turns out to be real? Do you want it to be a remake slash remaster of old Banjo games, or do you want it to be a completely brand new game? Let me know why or why not in the comment section below. And yeah, thank you so much for this. And again, thank you so much for all your support on the last Banjo video. I really appreciate it. Okay, everyone, please give this video a thumbs up if you like it. Subscribe to my channel if you like videos like these, want to see more in the future. Follow me on Twitter or Twitch and join my Discord server, the Spongy Garden. Now, this is Riders riding out. A quick shout out to my special duckies, Reese Gaming and Sodden Grider. You would like to become a duckie, then please check out either my YouTube membership or my Patreon in the description box below. Thank you.